We want to welcome our viewers in the United States and around the world. This is New Day. It is Monday, October 29th, 6 o'clock here in New York. And we do start with breaking news. This out of Indonesia. That's where a passenger plane has crashed with 189 people on board into the Java Sea. There is a frantic search for survivors at this hour, so we will have much more on all of that in a moment. But first, hate crimes and violence rattling America. Thousands, capping a week where 14 mail bombs were sent around the country to targets of President Trump's and to this network. And in Kentucky, two African Americans were killed by a gunman at a supermarket. And we're now learning that that gunman tried to enter a black church minutes before that attack.
The president
with us. We had some technological problems as we were trying to go to our guests, Fred and Jesse Rabner, to talk about the shooting at their synagogue, at the Tree of Life Synagogue in Pittsburgh. So, Fred and Jesse, can you guys hear me now? Hate-filled crimes, including a massacre at a Pittsburgh synagogue. Then a dozen mail bombs were sent to people that President Trump had criticized. And a deadly shooting at a supermarket that appears to be racially motivated. So joining us now is former Secretary Johnson. Thank you very much for being here. If you were Secretary today of Homeland Security and there was this spate of hate crimes, what would you and your president do?
Well,
that President Trump's words are leading to violence. The current Secretary of Homeland Security setting the tone, Kirstjen Nielsen, they're talking a lot about the caravan. And we know that the gunman in Pittsburgh drew a connection between his fear and his hatred of the caravan or invaders and what he did. And so, do you see a connection between that and what the president has focused on and this violence?
Allison, I'm very distraught.
Homeland Security, Kirstjen Nielsen was at the border doing an interview with the Fox Channel.
Yes.
And talking about, you know, all of the perceived dangers of what might happen, hypothetically, if this caravan were to, on foot, make it the 2,000 miles to the U.S. border. Should that have been her top priority last week?
When I was in office, Allison.
Last week, the domestic terrorism was here. It was inside the U.S. Those were
correct.
The biggest threats, from receiving bombs, these
correct.
Improvised explosive devices, to obviously these crazed gunmen. And so what do you wish that Kirstjen Nielsen had said during all of that?
Well, for starters,
Security Jay Johnson, thank you very
thank you.
Much for being here with your expertise. John.